and I stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch, try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the street, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. They just use your mind and they never save, give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5 for service and devotion. You would think that I would deserve a fair promotion, wanna move ahead, but the boss won't seem to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me. You dream just to watch him shatter. You're just a step on the boss man's ladder, but you got dreams he'll never take away. You're in the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in. The tide's gonna turn, all gonna roll your way. Working 9 to 5, what a way to wake a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. Wanna use your head, but the boss won't seem to let you. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, they got you where they want you. There's a better life, and you think about it, don't you? It's a rich man's game, no matter what they call it, and you spend your life putting money in his wallet. Working 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. They just use your mind and never give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5 for service and devotion. You would think that I would deserve a fair promotion. Wanna move ahead, but the boss won't seem to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me. 9 to 5. 9 to 5. 9 to 5. Billy's place, the vibe is light and breezy. Billy's place, it's a virtual speakeasy. My home base, I'm glad that you dropped by. Time to grab a libation from the shelf. Have whatever you want, you gotta make it yourself. Sit back, relax, I'll make your troubles fly. A musical trip, nothing complicated, and if you tip, that's appreciated. Good fellowship with no mask on our face. From apartment 5 across the park, singing and swinging till it gets dark. Don't worry about finding a place to park, just park it at Billy's place. Park it at Billy's place. Well, good evening, everybody. It's Sunday, August 29th, a special edition of Billy's Place, episode 60. All right, we've hit the 60 mark. And tonight we are shining the spotlight on 3 of our favorite country ladies, Dolly Parton, Trisha Yearwood, and Wynonna Judd. So sit back, relax, it's going to be a lot of fun. I hope there's a nice crowd watching tonight, because it's a different night, but you know, we'll see. Those of you that are here, I'm so glad you're here. Just sit back, relax, enjoy the hour. I'm thrilled to be here. Just park it at Billy's Place. Gonna continue with another great Dolly Parton song, but I slowed it down a bit. Mm-hmm. just when I've begun to get myself together. You waltz right through the door, just like you've done before, and wrap your heart round your little finger. Here you come again. Just when I'm about to make it work without you, you look right into my eyes and lie those pretty lies. And pretty soon I'm wondering how I came to doubt you. All you gotta do is smile that smile, and there go all my defenses. Just leave it up to you, and in a little while you're messing up my mind, filling up my senses. Here you come again, looking better than a body has a right to, and shaking me up so that all I really know is here you come again. And here I go. Just leave it up to you, and in a little while you're messing up my mind, filling up my senses. Here you come again, looking better than a body has a right to, and shaking me up so that all I really know is here you come again. And here I go. Here I go. Here you come again. Come Again, one of my favorite Dolly Parton songs, written by Barry Mann and Cynthia Weil, and which I love. I mean, I love that, but I like doing it slow too. It's kind of cool, right? It's such a great melody, and I like how it shifts keys around, and it's great. Anyway, enough about that. Hello, everybody. Happy Sunday. I'm so glad that you're with me tonight on this special Sunday night. As you know, we had to preempt our skip last Thursday because I was out of town. I was playing a gig at a beautiful new club outside of Indianapolis. It's called Feinstein's at the Carmel, at the Carmichael, the Hotel Carmichael, which is in Carmel, Indiana, which is about 40 minutes north of Indianapolis. And it's this beautiful town and gorgeous five-star hotel with just a great, great cabaret to work in. And I had the best time. And that's where Michael Feinstein has started the American Songbook Foundation. and they have all the archives there. They have an exhibit actually at the beautiful Palladium Theater there, but then about a mile off-site in a, you know, it looks like an office park, is where they keep the archives. And I walk in there and I swear it's floor to ceiling. It's like all the collections of Meredith Wilson and Gus Kahn, and they just acquired all of Andy Williams' charts and orchestrations from like 11 years of the Andy Williams Show, just like, you know, shelves upon shelves upon shelves. And it's a great place because their purpose there is to not only keep them safe and keep them secure and protected, but also to make it accessible to future generations of singers. Like if, you know, I assume if I wanted to do an Andy Williams show with a big band, I could, you know, go to Carmel and basically probably borrow the charts. So it's fantastic that this place exists. And along the way, I mentioned this, if you follow me on Facebook or Instagram, you saw this, but a cool thing is that Chris Lewis, who gave me the tour, he's the head of the foundation there at the Palladium, he said, "You got to see Johnny Mercer's piano." So I'm like, he's leading me around, and I think that we're going to go to some room and see this beautiful grand piano. And no, it's this spinet piano. It's like a piano that, you know, anybody would have in their house in the 50s or the 40s. But it, not impressive at all, except for the fact that Johnny Mercer played it and possibly wrote a lot of great songs. People think of him primarily as a lyricist, but he wrote great melodies. "Dream When You're Feeling Blue," that's one of his great melodies. And so I made a little film of me playing that song. And it was very cool to see that and to see the whole place. So if you're just joining us, I'm Billy Stritch. Do me a favor and hit the bottom button right below the screen that says share. And share that with your Facebook, on your Facebook page. And also, I always forget the things to say. So follow me on Instagram, Billy Stritch on Instagram. Please follow me there because I'm posting lots of fun stuff every week. You know, things from my past and not just gigs coming up, but, you know, great memories that pop up. And also on YouTube, where all these shows get uploaded, my Billy Stritch channel. Please go and subscribe to that. If you're able to send us a tip, that is great. We are still asking for tips, even though I'm out working somewhat in the world. You know, we do the setup, we pay for the ring lights, we pay for this camera. We just bought a new hard drive, a wonderful new computer with a ton more memory. We bought that about 3 weeks ago. So we're always trying to upgrade. So anything you sit in on PayPal or Venmo is really, really appreciated. And what else? I always feel like there's something else I'm forgetting. Is that it, Doug? Doug said that's good.
You know, we have people watching all over the country, all over the world. We actually have people who are watching while they're on the train.
Oh, yeah. Bill and Ernie, they said they might be watching on a train. They watch every week, and I knew they were going to be taking this wonderful Amtrak train journey. They're going through the great Northwest. They're in Montana on their way to Seattle, and you're watching me tonight. Isn't that... that blows my mind. I love it that you're watching me. I think my friend Connor and Sarum are watching in London because tomorrow is a bank holiday in London. So they usually, it's 1 o'clock when my shows appear there. And sometimes they stay up that late, but more often than not, they watch it the next day on YouTube. But I think they said they were going to try to stay up because they don't have to work tomorrow, which I do love. So it's just great. Deep brewed flavor. Lauren McCall, deep brewed flavor. Let's just move on with it. This is a song, this actually occurred to me yesterday to do this song. It's a song that I used to sing all the time in the 80s. I was with a vocal group called Montgomery, Plant, and Stritch. We were a nightclub act, and we worked a lot of supper clubs and cabarets all through Texas and Arkansas and in New York at the Algonquin. But in Texas, this really went over well. We used to do a medley of songs from a wonderful show that I love called Pump Boys and Dinettes. And this song actually really fits. I used to sing this song. I haven't sung it in 35 years, but I think I might remember it. ¶¶ It was late after the show. I was in love, I couldn't go. I waited by the stage door for her. Security was tight, but somehow I knew it was my night. Our meeting was destined to occur. Then suddenly there she was, flashbulbs flashing off her smile, full figured in a low-cut gown. Good golly, she had style. And it was me she smiled upon in that line, and I felt Dolly Parton was almost mine. I didn't know I had the strength to speak, but I said, "You were fine." The night Dolly Parton was almost mine. She was my first love in country music, my first and only one true love. "Come on, Bill," she said, "Bill. I guess you ripped my name from off of my shirt. Come on, Bill. The bus is waiting. We'll have a private concert." Well, no one had to paint me a sign. I knew Dolly Parton was almost mine. So I plugged in the new Yamaha. She brought the French white wine. The night Dolly Parton was almost mine. She was my first love in country music, my first and only one true love. I got off in Hickory Bend. Sometimes a man has got to live with being just a friend. Though I only kissed her cheek, it was sweeter than the wine. The night Dolly Parton was almost mine. We were close enough to touch. The memory makes me shine. The night Dolly Parton was almost mine. She was my first love in country music, my first and only one true love. Yeehaw! The night Dolly Parton was almost mine. She was my first love in country music. That's almost true for me, actually. I've loved Dolly for so long. And God, I really love her now. I announced this news a few weeks ago when I first found out. But back in the 80s, my friend Sandy Knox and I co-wrote a song called "Does He Love You?" And we wrote it originally for my vocal group. It was two girls and me, Sharon Montgomery and Rebecca Plant. And we used to sing it in those cabarets, and people loved it because one plays a wife and one plays the mistress, and it's very dramatic the way they did it, you know. No one could remember the name of the song, so they just called it "The Bitch Fight," because, you know, they kind of turn and they really go at each other at the end. Anyway, flash forward to 1993. The song gets heard and discovered and cut by Reba McEntire and Linda Davis, and it became a number one country song, a multi-million selling record, as evidenced by, can you see this? That is, that's the one thing I got for the 3 million selling. It's from an album called Greatest Hits Volume 2. And that's when the album sold 3 million. It's gone on to sell in excess of 5 million because it appeared on a collection called Reba's Number Ones. But I digress, because on October 8th, a whole new version of the song. And Doug, I didn't even tell you this. Two versions of the song are coming out. Reba has a whole collection. It's a three album, three CD collection. It's called Revisited, Remastered, Renegotiated. I don't know. Regurgitated. Regurgitated. Anyway, she took hits and fan favorites, and she's redone them. And so she took the version that she did with Linda Davis. I guess they're re-recording it. She's re-recording it with Linda, which I just found out. That's going to be one version. But she's also recorded it with Dolly Parton. And I'm so excited about that. So that will be out in about 5 weeks' time. I haven't heard it yet, but I'm so thrilled that that's going to happen. So, Dolly, wherever you are, I love you. I hope I get a chance to hang out with Dolly. Wouldn't that be fun? Anyway, that was kind of like my tribute to Dolly. There's so many great songs. You know, we're celebrating three great country ladies tonight. But, you know, and there's so many songs from each one of them, it's really hard to choose. But the second one is the one that is so near and dear to Doug's heart. It's his favorite singer, and I have to say it's one of my top favorite singers as well. Doug is a huge, huge fan of Trisha Yearwood, who has got the most wonderful voice. If you're familiar with her at all, you know how great. She also has the greatest taste in songs. She's had some wonderful songs, really, with great lyrics, and we're going to do some of those for you tonight. But Doug met Trisha, I'm sorry. Doug met Trisha many, many years ago. He'll tell you about this later, but when she was really just starting out, really on her first tour, Doug got to see her at the State Fair, right? The Big E State Fair, and became a member of her fan club, and has met her on many occasions. There's a picture of the two of them together. Are you going to show that? Oh, that's good. And then about four or five years ago, Trisha was doing a cookbook signing at Williams-Sonoma, which is about a block away from us at Columbus Circle. And so we went over there with our dog, Minnie, and saw her there. And there's a picture of us with Trisha and Minnie. And we also went up to see her at Mohican Sun, or was it Foxwoods? It was Foxwoods. We went up and saw her there about 4 years ago. Doug has seen her many more times than I have, but she's just fabulous. He loves her so much so that I think he probably wants to tell you about it himself. So here's a moment that a lot of you have been waiting for. I'm going to move out just so you can move in, but here is our producer, our trusty stalwart producer, and my partner, Doug Major.
Come on in here, baby.
I'm coming in.
You got your phone there in case you need to look
at it. Oh, no, I need that.
Yeah, you need the phone. Okay. Yeah.
I said, yeah. I see you got your phone. We have a signal planned with one of our, you can tell them all that stuff.
So here you go. And just make sure you switch that mic on.
Phone off, mic on.
Phone off, mic on. Yes. And he's gonna. You're going to perch there. Perch. Hi.
Hello. How are you?
Hello. Hello, everybody. Hi.
Yeah, he's got it set up so that if we can't hear him or something really goes
I told
on.
Somebody trustworthy, if just something's really wrong, to please text me. And if I see a text come through from this person, I know I've got to stop and go back to my station.
Right.
And if she was evil and mean sibling like I am to her, she would do that.
No, she won't do it. She's not going to do it. Nothing happening yet.
Nothing yet. Okay,
it's good. It's good. So you first heard Trisha in...
I've been a fan since the moment I heard She's in Love with the Boy on the Radio when it first came out. And here's why we're doing this week. It's our 60th show. And it coincides with the 30th anniversary of She's in Love with the Boy. And it's a historic single in country music because it is the first single in country music history by a female artist debut to go to number one. And it recently was certified as country music's radio most played song by a female artist.
Out of everything.
Out of everything, yes.
Wow, that is really incredible.
So, yeah. Congratulations to Trisha Yearwood.
Absolutely.
On that. Yes,
it's a great song. Yeah. Doug, there's not a day that goes by that I don't hear Doug singing either Trisha Yearwood or Carpenters, one of the two.
Well, you know, I love people who watch the show regularly know I love The Wizard of Oz, I love The Carpenters, I love Olivia Newton-John and Grease. I love those things so much, but I've only joined one fan club in my entire life, and that was the Trisha Yearwood fan club.
Yeah.
And it was so sweet. I saw her at the Big E. I was covering it for the newspaper I worked
for.
That's
the New England State
the
Fair,
Big,
right?
The New England State Fair. And I was taking pictures for the newspaper, and she was, you know, pretty new within the first year of her success. And I walked right up to the edge of the stage, and she was just posing for me in these pictures. So I was captivated right away. And then I was leaving the fairground, and as I got to the gate, the limo pulls up, and it's got to be her, because who else at the fair would have a limo?
Right.
And I took the picture out that had come in the little press kit, and I just held it up. The windows were dark, and I held it up, and the window goes down. And she took the picture, and she signed it for me, and here's where she got me. She hands it back to me. She goes, "Now blow on it for a minute so the signature doesn't smudge." She cared.
She cared.
And I absolutely. Just, yeah.
Yep.
And
Trisha cares.
I was just immediately smitten and have been ever since. Yes.
You want to sing this song?
I do.
Okay.
I think so.
All right. Here we go.
Here we go. Katie's sitting on her old front porch, watching the chickens peck the ground. There ain't a whole lot going on tonight in this one horse town. Over yonder, coming up the road in a beat up Chevy truck, her boyfriend Tommy is laying on the horn, splashing through the mud and the muck. Her daddy says he ain't worth a lick. When it comes to brains, he got the short end of the stick. But Katie's young and man, she just don't care. She'd follow Tommy anywhere. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. And even if they have to run away, she's gonna marry that boy someday. Katie and Tommy at the drive-in movie, parked in the very last row. They're too busy holding on to one another to even care about the show. Later on outside the Tasty Freeze, Tommy slips something on her hand. He says, "My high school ring will have to do till I can buy a wedding band." Her daddy says he ain't worth a lick. When it comes to brains, he got the short end of the stick. But Katie's young and man, she just don't care. She'd follow Tommy anywhere. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. And even if they have to run away, she's gonna marry that boy someday. Her daddy's waiting up till 12:30 when they come sneaking up the walk. He says, "Young lady, get on up to your room while me and Junior have a talk." Mama breaks in, says, "Don't lose your temper. It wasn't very long ago that you yourself was just a hayseed plowboy who didn't have a row to hoe." My daddy said, "You wasn't worth a lick. When it came to brains, you got the short end of the stick." But he was wrong, and honey, you are too. Katie looks at Tommy like I still look at you. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. What's meant to be will always find a way. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. She's in love with the boy. What's meant to be will always find a way. She's gonna marry that boy someday.
She's in love.
She's in love with the boy.
She's in love with the boy.
You think they got married?
I think they got married. I think they've been together for 30 years.
30 years. Love that song. Doug Major, everybody. Come on. I mean, that was great.
That was fun.
That was fun.
It's
Did you enjoy it?
It's a fun song to sing.
It's a fun song to sing.
Yeah.
Good.
It's
good,
a fun
good.
Song to listen to, too. That's why it's the most played.
Yeah, I know.
By a female country artist.
Gets played all the time, yeah. Right? Yeah. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Now, we worked out another one to sing, right?
We did, yes.
Yeah. Do you want to say anything about this?
I do, yeah. This was from her second album. This is when I met her. Her second album had just come out. And this is one of the big hits from that album. And it was a video, you know, they made country music videos back then, and the male character in this story was played in the video by Matthew McConaughey. It was
right.
His very first on-camera performance that he was paid for, yeah.
Oh, it was? I didn't realize
it was the first thing he'd ever done. Yeah,
wow, okay, yeah. So look that up later on YouTube to see a very young Matthew McConaughey. Hey. Hey, Matthew. Hey, Colin.
Never mind.
Deep root flavor. Okay, so this, I love this song.
Yeah.
This is great. It's a great story.
Trisha Yearwood, too, she met this guy who recorded this song with her. She's, you know, she's smart, and she's kind of a little fierce, too, and she asked this man, who was his a legendary singer, if he gave her a compliment. She said, well, I'm recording my next record. Would you come sing with me? And they hadn't chosen the song, and then he said yes, and she got this song, and this is the one she asked him to sing.
And who's the guy?
His name is Mr. Don Henley of the Eagles.
Don Henley of the Eagles. Now, I'm going to sing his part, and not nearly as good as him. So anyway.
Well, I'm going to sing her part.
Anyway.
Well, that goes without saying.
It's okay.
Yeah.
You know what? If you're watching, you know, you like us. You love us. You're supportive.
You want some more of us?
You want to like it. I love it. I want some more of it.
Okay. Mama told her baby girl, take it real slow. Girl told her mama, hey, I really gotta go. He's waiting in the car. Mama said, girl, you won't get far. Thus are the dreams of an average Jane. 90 miles an hour down a lover's lane. On a tank of dreams. Oh, if she could have only seen. But fate's got cards that it don't want to show. And that boy's just a walk away Joe. Born to be a lever, tell you from the word go. Destined to deceive her, he's the wrong kind of paradise. She's gonna know it in a matter of time. That boy's just a walk away, Joe. Now just a little while into Abilene. Pulls into a station and he robs it clean. She's waiting in the car underneath the Texaco star. She only wanted love, didn't bargain for this. She can't help but love him for the way he is. She's only 17, and there ain't no reason. So she'll ride this ride as far as it can go. 'Cause that boy's just a walk away Joe. Born to be a lever, tell you from the word go. Destined to deceive her, he's the wrong kind of paradise. She's gonna know it in a matter of time. That boy's just a walk away Joe. Somewhere in a roadside motel room, alone in the
the silence, she wakes up too soon and reaches for his arm. But she'll just keep reaching on. For the cold, hard truth revealed what it had known. Was a walk away Joe, born to be a lever, tell you from the word go, destined to deceive her. He's the wrong kind of paradise, but it was just another lesson in life. That boy was a walk away Joe. All he was a walk away Joe. Was a walk away Joe.
Yeah. Ah, sad song, right? Yeah, so she got left alone.
She got left alone, but since he was a walk away Joe, she had the car still, so she was all right.
Oh, that's okay. So she made it back home. That's good. All right, good. Well, that was fun. Did you enjoy singing?
I did.
Good, good.
See, the thing is, folks, I have to do all the setup of the audio stuff and everything, and some of our stuff is still new to me, and the part of my brain that does that and the part of my brain that can sing are different, and they weren't getting along, and it makes it a little...
Honey, you're doing a good job. Yeah. Don't sweat it. It's you're okay, doing a good fun. Job.
But I love Trisha and I love those songs. I turned my microphone off while I was talking there because I got the turn.
Yeah, don't turn. Just don't.
Leave. I'm not made for this.
No. That's okay. It's on that. It's okay.
Okay.
What else do you want to say?
Well, about this song, the next one coming up.
Oh, okay.
Up.
Yeah.
This is a really lovely song, and when this album was being released, her third album, I was in Nashville, and I was wondering if she'd have some sort of a showcase or something that I could go to, and I sent a fax. To the fan club.
Of course, a fax.
Back then, it was a fax. And I got the loveliest note back in the loveliest handwriting from her mother explaining that she wasn't going to be in Nashville. And anyway, what I did while I was in Nashville, I went to see the taping of a show on the Nashville network called Music City Tonight, starring Lorianne Crook and Charlie Chase.
Crook and Chase.
And I was so excited because they had a good lineup that night. Aaron Tippin, who was a big country music star at the time, was there.
Yep.
As was Reba McEntire and her friend Linda Davis debuting their brand new single, Does He Love You? I saw them do it live.
Isn't that weird?
I had years before I would meet him.
6 years before we met.
Yeah.
Yep. That's
right. Sandy Knox, your co-writer, was there that night. And you know.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Oh, that was an exciting time, but I love that you were there. I mean, that's just like so weird.
That's wonderful. And
this song is, so I'm going to sing the song, right? You want to stay here while I sing it? Or you want to go back there?
Well, are you going to talk about our friend who recorded it with you?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to.
This is,
yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
One of my favorite things was that night we went to see Trisha Yearwood with her, and she was...
That's right. Well, this is a song that my friend, actually Jim Caruso and I both... played this song for our wonderful dear friend Linda Lavin, and she fell in love with it several years ago, and she sang it in her act for a long time, and I believe she recorded it on the first album she did, which was called Possibilities. And so this is a song that I always think of Linda, and actually this is the first time I've sung it. Linda does such a great job on the song, but she's not here. But Linda, if you're listening and you might be watching this later, you just know that I'm thinking of you. And thanks for letting me borrow this song. It was written by Hugh Prestwood. And it's from an album of the same name called The Song Remembers When.
Also, The Song Remembers When, the album, Trisha Yearwood wanted to thank her fans for their support, and the motif of the album is sunflowers, which is why we have these here tonight.
That's right.
These are to thank Trisha Yearwood, of course, for the music, but mostly for the Billy's Place viewers. They're,
yeah.
It's our
60
our,
episodes, yeah. Guys. Thank you so much. Yeah. So. Yeah.
I can get out of here and leave you alone.
You're going to get out of here and go see.
I do want to tell them about the night Trisha Yearwood.
Tell them.
No, we went to Linda Lavin took us to see Trisha Yearwood.
To say, yeah, go ahead.
She took us to see Trisha Yearwood
about
2 years ago at Town Hall here in New York. It was the funniest night. Linda and her husband Steve and Billy and I, we were all exhausted for different reasons. We went to dinner and we went to the show and we were sitting upstairs.
And it started late. She didn't get up.
And I would never, ever, like, and we had, he had. backstage, passes to the party after the show downtown. He got, and we were so tired, all of us. I was having this horrible job at the time that we didn't go. But the best part of that was when she started singing the song. Remembers when looking at Linda Lavin screaming and crying because she was so happy. It was really great.
And she sang the song. Trisha sang it beautifully. And there was huge applause. We were happy. And then we looked at each other and went, are you ready? Are you ready to go now?
Yeah.
So we actually, Trisha, if you're watching, because I know you are, sorry we left your show early, but we heard
I had to be really tired to do that. It was I can't stay up anymore. Yeah.
No, we were exhausted. We heard what we wanted to hear.
It was a memory. The song remembers when. All right. I'll leave you alone now.
All right. That's okay. Yeah. Turn that off and leave that there. I'll let you out.
Thanks.
Yep. Go back and look at the comments and see if they can hear you.
Go back and see if anyone's still watching.
Exactly. All right.
That was fun. So this song, written by Hugh Prestwood, and I love the lyric to this song. You know, it's how songs, you can hear a song and it takes you right back to where you were the first time you hear it. Linda always opens, she sets up the song, she goes, takes you back to a smell or a place or just a great memory. And sometimes it's a happy memory, sometimes it is. I was standing at the counter, I was waiting for the change, when I heard that old familiar music start. It was like a lighted match had been tossed into my soul. It was like a dam had broken in my heart. After taking every detour, getting lost and losing track, so that even if I wanted, I could not find my way back. After driving out the memory of the way things might have been, after I had forgotten all about us, the song remembers when. We were rolling through the Rockies, we were up above the clouds, when a station out of Jackson played that song. And it seemed to fit the moment, and the moment seemed to freeze, when we turned the music up and sang along. And there was a God in heaven, and the world made perfect sense. We were young and in love, we were easy to convince. We were headed straight for Eden, it was just around the bend. And though I had forgotten all about it, the song remembers when. I guess something must have happened, and we must have said goodbye, and my heart must have been broken, though I can't recall just why. The song remembers when. Well, for all the miles between us, and for all the time that's passed, you would think I haven't gotten very far. And I hope my hasty heart will forgive me just this once, if I stop to wonder how on earth you are. But that's just a lot of water underneath the bridge I burned. And there's no use in backtracking around corners I have turned. Still, I guess some things we bury are just bound to rise again. And even if the whole world had forgotten, the song remembers when. Yeah, even if the whole world has forgotten, the song remembers when. love that one. I love that one. I love the lyric. It really just tells exactly how music makes you feel and the memories that music can bring up. All right, I'm going to move on to Wynonna now, because Wynonna is someone that I have loved, well, since the Judds, of course, and they, I guess the Judds, I kind of remember them popping up and starting to record maybe in the very late 80s, early 90s, and then Wynonna, of course, went on to have this incredible solo career. So I just love her voice. I love her look. I love her. She's got a lot of power. Anyway, if you just joined us, it's Billy's Place. And if you're able to send a donation, a virtual tip, that would be just wonderful. You can do it through PayPal, and you can do it through Venmo. And if you don't like to use those online apps, you can write me on Facebook Messenger, and I'll send you an address where you can send a check. How about that?
Did we forget about the captain when I came up, my brother?
Oh, you know what? I did forget about that. I knew when I said, is there something I forgot? Of course. Oh, thank you for reminding me. Oh, yeah, we have a special announcement. Doug has a special announcement to make on behalf of his family. Doug's brother, Patrick, who is a longtime member of the Chicopee Police Force in Chicopee, Massachusetts, just got promoted to captain of... There's nothing higher than captain, right? I mean, that's the highest thing. Yeah, right. That's like, I think that's pretty much it. He is the captain now of the Chicopee Police Force, and there's a picture of him. He's Captain Major. I love that. Captain Major. Captain Patrick Major of the Chicopee Police Force. Congratulations to you. That is really pretty fabulous. And we applaud you, and we're sending our love. All right. Here's a song Wynonna recorded in 1996 on an album called Revelations. If I could reach the stars, pull one down for you, shine it on my heart so you could see the truth that this love I have inside is everything it seems. But for now, it's only in my dreams. If I could change the world, I would be the sunlight in your universe. You would think my love was really something good, baby, if I could change the world. If I could be a king, even for a day, I'd take you as my queen. I'd have it no other way. And our love would rule in this kingdom we have made. Then I'd be a fool, wishing for the day that I could change the world. I would be the sunlight in your universe. You would think my love was really something good, baby, if I could change. Baby, if I could change the world.
sunlight in your universe. You would think my love was really something good, baby, if I could change. Baby, if I could change. Baby, if I could change the world. If I could change the world. Love that song. If I could change the world. This next song is a song that she recorded in 1993, and it's from an album called Tell Me Why. And this song just killed me the first time I heard it. Hard to believe it was that long ago. It doesn't seem like it was that long ago to me, but it was written by a really talented Nashville songwriter named Billy Kirsch. He's written some terrific songs. But this is one of the best. It's sad, but I love it. This is called Is It Over Yet? Tell me when I can open my eyes. I don't want to watch you walk out that door. There's no easy way to get through goodbye. I'll probably try and talk you into staying once more. Or I'll lie and say it's all for the best. Wish you luck and say I have no regrets. But I'm not up to being strong, so I'll wait until you're gone. Is it over yet? Is it over yet? Taxi's waiting in the driveway for you. You call my name, I guess you're ready to leave. I'd like to help you with a suitcase or two, but I'm afraid it's gonna wind up down on my knees. I should tell you that I want you to go. I really need to spend some time on my own. Smile and say goodbye, so you don't see me dying inside. Is it over yet? Is it over yet. I should lie and say it's all for the best. Wish you luck and say I have no regrets. But I'm not up to being strong, so I'll wait until you're gone. Is it over yet? Is it over? Is it over?
Oh, that song kills me every time. I hope you enjoyed it, Joe. I hope you like the songs that I picked tonight. Like I said before, there are so many great songs to choose from, and it's really hard to just narrow it down. So I'm sure I'm probably going to miss some of your favorites, but I hope that I really get in the ones you like. If you're just joining us or if you're having a good time and you're able to send a little love our way, please don't hesitate to do that on PayPal or Venmo. There are the addresses on the screen. And no amount is too small, and certainly no amount is too large. Having a great time celebrating three of our favorite country women stars, icons. It's just fantastic. It's a different show for us, but I'm having a good time doing it. Couple more songs to go, and this is another Wynonna song, which I love. Okay. I've been a rock and I've got my fences. I never let them down. When it comes to love, I keep my senses. I don't get kicked around. I shivered once. You broke into my soul. The damage is done. Now I'm out of control. How did you get to me? No one else on earth could ever hurt me. Break my heart the way you do. No one else on earth was ever worth it. No one could love me like, no one could love me like you. Can make me want you anytime you want to. You're burning me alive. I can't deny you, even when I catch you weaving a weak alibi. 'Cause when the night falls, you make me forget your love is killing me, and it ain't over yet. How did you get to me? No one else on earth could ever hurt me, break my heart the way you do. No one else on earth was ever worth it. No one could love me like, no one could love me like you. Broken to my soul, the damage is done. Now I'm out of control. How did you get to me? No one else on earth could ever hurt me and break my heart the way you do. No one else on earth was ever worth it. No one could love me like a, no one could love me. No one else on earth could ever. No one could love me like no one like you. No one like you. No one else on earth could ever break me. No one could love me like no one can love me like you. Wynonna Judd, I hope you like that. Whew, this is real different for me, guys. I know if you watch me, you know I'm singing like, it's very clear, our love is here to stay, and stuff like that that's really within my wheelhouse. But this has been a nice challenge. You know, that's what I try to do from time to time, is really kind of throw myself into the deep end of the pool and do some stuff that I'm not quite known for, or that I don't do that much. Maybe you have to work a little extra for it. And I hope that you enjoyed it, because, you know, we got through it. That's the thing. Thank you, Doug, for coming to sing and telling your stories about Trisha. I loved it. He got through it. He said, thank you for getting me through it. But you got through it really, really nicely. All right. So I want to tell you, I'm very sad to say that this is going to be our last live stream for a while because I'm heading off to Provincetown on Tuesday for a 2-week engagement. I can't even believe it. 2-week engagement with the marvelous Marilyn May. We usually always do a week toward the end of August, early September. We've been there 10 years and we usually 5 or 6 nights. This year it's 2 weeks. I'm going to go stir crazy. I'm just saying. I mean, I know none of you have pity for me because I'm getting a chance to go to Provincetown, which is lovely. And, it's a great town and I'm seeing lots of old friends, but, there's only so many times you can walk up and down Commercial Street. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I'll be back in town. We work from, August 31st. And we close our engagement there on the 11th, coming back the 12th. And I will be back at Billy's place on the 16th. So that is about 2.5 weeks from now, right? You want to tell me something?
Did you say hi to Kelly for her birthday?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. It's like
August 31st.
Kelly, our friend Kelly, his birthday is August 31st. Kelly, we love you, Kelly. And it's going to be your birthday. We were at your, and happy anniversary. Because it's her anniversary, too, because she got married on her birthday. So that was because so her husband wouldn't forget her birthday, I think. Or maybe he forgets both. I don't know.
But he remembers the day Princess Diana died.
Oh, yeah. He remembers because Princess Diana died on that day. And that really made Kelly upset because it's like now every year people are going to say that. Anyway, I'm sure she didn't mean it personally. Kelly, happy birthday. Anyway, so everybody, I will be back on September 16th. For episode 61. I'm not sure what it's going to be. I'm going to do a Rosemary Clooney episode. I've gotten like 3 requests for that. And that's one that, God, there's great songs there. So that might be it. If you have any ideas for songs you'd like to hear, concepts, shows, I've also got a concept to do a Dorothy Field show, which is great. I've done a lot of her material, but that could be a show. I'm open to ideas because after 60 episodes, it's like, okay, we got to keep them fresh. So the way to do that is to write me through the Facebook Messenger app. And that way I will see your message. It won't get buried with the comments for the show. All right. I'm going to close with a song that everyone knows, written in 1973. Dolly Parton wrote this. It was inspired by she had worked for so many years with Porter Wagoner. And when they broke up after working together for probably 10 years, she wrote this song for him. And we all know that it was a hit for Dolly. But maybe what you don't know is that after it was a hit for Dolly, Elvis called up Dolly and really wanted to record the song. This was right after Dolly had a recording with it. She was thrilled. He loved it. I mean, can you imagine? It would have been fantastic. And Colonel Tom Parker said, well, you know, that's fine, except we have to have half the publishing. That was the way he was. Anything that Elvis recorded, they got half of, at least half, shady. But that's the way that was. And Dolly just over the phone said, you know, I can't do that. And she says she was heartbroken and she cried many tears about it, but she just didn't feel right giving away half the rights to that song. And then she went on to say that when Whitney Houston recorded it and sold so much, she ended up making so much money she could have bought Graceland. And that's absolutely true. So this is a great song that all of you know, and I'm just going to end tonight with this wonderful, very well-known Dolly Parton song. Dolly, I love you. I love you. I can't wait to hear the recording with Reba McEntire. That's coming out on October 8th. I'm thrilled about it. So anyway, and thank you so much for tuning in tonight on Sunday. I appreciate it. If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go I'll think of you each step of the way. And I will always love you. I will always love you. Bittersweet memories. That's all I'm taking with me. So goodbye. Please don't cry. We both know I'm not what you need. And thank you very much. I'll see you on September 16th. Thanks for tuning in. Love you. Bye.